The first thing we have to remember is John Archer's born in 1863. He's born in Liverpool of English and Bayesian parentage. He then goes missing for about 30 years and re-emerges in London after travelling the world three times. He comes back with a fantastic, black, gorgeous Canadian woman. And they set up in Battersea, in a place called Bryner Road, 55 Bryner Road. And within 8 years of him coming back, he's elected councillor, the first black councillor we have on record in London, with a man called Henry Sylvester Williams. That's quite interesting, because you have to understand, to be a councillor, you are elected by your peers, by your colleagues, and of course all of them were white. 7 years after that, he becomes elected mayor. By one single vote, he becomes the mayor of Battersea, and he changes the history of London forever by becoming the most prominent black face in black politics, certainly in London, and arguably in Britain. And after that, in 1918, he is re-elected as a councillor, this time on a different ticket, this time by the Labour Party. He's an agent for a number of people, including electing the first Asian mayor of the 20th century, also in Battersea, actually. He becomes the deputy leader of the Labour Party, which of course at that time is, if not the largest, and certainly the second largest party in Britain. He's a fantastic example of someone who's achieved despite all the odds, and we are absolutely delighted to have studied him and got these young people involved. And we have now placed a plaque on his former address, which is 214 Battersea Park Road. It's been an honour to pay tribute to such a wonderful, remarkable man.
The Trust Nubian Jack has set up on 214 Battersea Road a blue plaque for him in his honour. And we hope many people, when they look at it, will get to know who he is.
Why should we know about Battersea's dog home and John Archer is not known of? We got to change it. I'm not chasing the dogs from Battersea, but we got to make known that we have a great figure, a great role model, and we're going to change this celebrity role model. So let's get into history. Let's dig the depth of history to make role models out of it so that you all can be inspired to aspire. That's how I want to see things go.
Give me some claps for the fingers, man. And all here, one, two. One, two, three, four. That's better.
Guns are fancy beat. Beep, beep, beep. Guns are fancy beat.
One of the interesting questions that I'm trying to unlock is more about John Archer's personal life. And one of them is about what were his tastes in music. We know he was a good friend of Samuel Coleridge Taylor, the black British composer and musician, whose famous work is the Hiawatha. John Archer was particularly affected by his death. He regarded him as a great loss to him as a friend, but also to the race. We know he was at the funeral, but did he also go and see other black musical entertainers? Did, for instance, in 1908, did he go and see the smash hit US black show in Dahomey? When Paul Robeson was beginning to become popular in the late 1920s and performed Othello, was John Archer, did he manage to go and hear Paul Robeson and see him in Othello? It's interesting, for example, that in May 1919, when they had a big peace celebration dance at Battersea Town Hall, the band for the night was a black American jazz band. And I just wonder whether through his networks, Archer helped to get that contract for that band, because he would have probably have met the leader, Pollard, through his activities as the president of the African Progress Union, who would have been linking up with the black ex-servicemen who remained in Britain for a while after the end of the First World War.
Things don't change completely overnight, as John Archer was all too aware. Today, we celebrate the life of John Archer, widely seen as a role model in combating racial prejudice because of his success. As the present Mayor of Wandsworth, I'm proud to recall his pioneering political life, and he is rightly seen as a great predecessor.
We all remember his immense contribution to the politics of Battersea initially, and of course the Metropolitan Borough of Bath is now part of Wandsworth since 1969, London Borough of Wandsworth. But his contribution is recognised pretty well every week when we have citizenship ceremonies for those who want to those of foreign nationality who want to join the British family, as they say, in a global city, to point out that people from all sorts of different backgrounds are recognised and have been recognised for their abilities rather than from where they come from or what colour they happen to be. We've had black mayors recently. We had the Millennium Year. We had Lola Eyonrindi, a Nigerian lady, and she was mayor again 5 years later. So we're very happy to honour John Archer and recall his immense contribution. Well, it's a part of the heritage of the borough, and obviously we want to celebrate the heritage in its widest possible context.
And I'm as excited as you are for this history. Because when I was growing up, I didn't realize black people had history. You're living in a turn that is marvelous. You have teachers today that some of you may not recognize. They are fantastic. Why? Because they're able to look at the two sides of the coin. My father used to tell me there are three sides to every story: yours, mine, and the facts. It appears that Britain had something that they did not celebrate before America celebrated Obama. And it's a message. If we can take John Archer and make him ours, we can possibly say that there was some form of black recognition, or maybe not, in London.
I am a historian, oral historian, broadcaster, writer, working quite a lot in the field of creative education. And what I have back here to do today with Nubian Jack, working with children, bringing the history to them, along with Sean Crichton, the historian who actually discovered and brought this to life. What the children presented are reflections of what they got from this history. So I'm rather pleased with the work that the children have done. There's a lot of presentation skills one has to teach to many of them. They want to do it. They have, some of them are shy, capable, But they can be helped a lot with the parents, grandparents. You have a lot of history likewise to pass on to them. So I think today's beginning is an inspiration. And if we follow it up, we'll get a new generation of inspired people.
I mean, we've seen some of the work that the children have done, and it's been very impressive. Can I ask what you'd hope they would take away from this project?
Well, I would hope they would take away a deeper insight into local history. I think it's very hard for children to have a connection with the area that they live in and what went on in the past. So it's good, I think, for them to dig deeper into local history. I think it's good also for them to get a clearer understanding of what it was like for a black man to have an impact in the early 20th century, as John Archer did, and how against the odds that was, and to take that into their own lives as, you know, a means of spurring them on to greater achievement themselves, and not looking at the obstacles, but what is possible for somebody to do.
My name is Ashawn.
Yep. And have you learnt? What have you learnt about John Archer so far?
He was the first black mayor in Battersea, and which meant he was the first black mayor of London. That everyone can try new things, and it doesn't matter if you're different colours or not.
The Heritage Lottery Fund contributed towards the series of workshops conducted with the five local schools, which have engaged over 100 students. These workshop sessions have provided training in researching, photography and public speaking. The funding has also contributed towards the production of the exhibition, which is shortly to start touring the libraries in Wandsworth. A project booklet and the installation of this plaque at the site of John Archer's photographic studio.
Is a quote. The people of Wandsworth have a long-standing reputation for tolerance and for valuing people by the contribution they make to society, rather than the colour of their skin, their ethnic origin, or their place of birth. And these are facts, not generalisations. People are frequently amazed to hear that London's first black mayor was elected in Battersea in 1913, 97 years ago. He is certainly not forgotten.
It has been 97 years, but it's not too late. It's not too late to honour this great man. So after three, everybody. One, two, three. Yeah! And that plaque is going to be there. Jonny to Archer! Jonny to Archer! All of your names are behind that plaque, remember that. So every time you walk past this plaque, you will know that you've had something to do with that, and that's going to be there forever, until that building's there, yeah? So wonderful, give yourselves a round of applause for that. Thank you very much.
I'm inspired by the concept of actually producing a plaque where children in year 10 and 11, at this stage in their life, have got their names on the back of a plaque. And in years to come, they'll be able to come back to this point at any point in time and say, I was part of that.